and cowboys and cowgirls, and welcome to day number one of the Canoe Mountain Rodeo right here in Belmont, British Columbia, brought to you by the British Columbia Rodeo Association. At this time, ladies and gentlemen, it's my great pleasure to introduce to you a fine group of youngsters, all the way from Hinton, Alberta, the Chinook Riders. Ladies and gentlemen, give them a big round of applause. Fighting horses, nor to never break a barrier. We do not ask for special favors. We do not ask for all daylight runs and not to draw steers that won't play. Well, help us, Lord, to live our lives in such a manner when we make the last inevitable ride to the country up there where the grass grows lush green and syrup high, the water runs cool, clear, and deep, that you, as our last judge, would tell us that our entry fees are paid. Amen, and ladies and gentlemen, get ready to Rodeo Heal This Weekend. And once again, as they leave the rodeo arena, ladies and gentlemen, the Chinook Riders, all the way from Hinton, Alberta. From the Alberta promised to be here this weekend. Now it is time to go down to the first section of the bareback bronc riding. In the bareback bronc riding this afternoon, we have just one cowboy ended up from Prince George, British Columbia. That'll be Jared Marshall. He's on a little horse called Ford Cobra. One of the horses raised with the WWE Rodeo Spring, that Ford and Buck Rodeo program. At the front feeder down on the ground, Jared Marshall will need to have a spur to the horn of the horse's shoulder. Nod the hand, there's your first bareback rider, Jared Marshall. Sit up and ride him, cowboy, ever ride. And that Jared Marshall is a true cowboy. Give him a big round of applause for the Prince George man, ladies and gentlemen. The judges tap in the score. We come back to you with some more rodeo action here this afternoon. That was Jared Marshall, Prince George cowboy. The javelin at a score of 1-25 with the riding ability of the cowboys. You have a little bit of trouble getting off the back of that horse. That'll help lock in there a little bit too tight. That means all using a bind. They use a bind, these cowboys, to keep the ham flipping out of the rig a little bit too quick. Jared Marshall, ladies and gentlemen, is a veteran cowboy, been riding bucking horses for many years and one of the best in the business. A 71, they tell me, ladies and gentlemen, a 7-1 for Jared Marshall in the first section of the bareback riding. You're going to see that cowboy back here later on for section number 2 in your rodeo program. But now we're down to the bucking chutes once again for the saddle bronc riding event. Been dubbed the classic event of rodeo many times over. In the saddle bronc riding event, you'll notice that the cowboys and cowgirls in this event, like I said, ladies and gentlemen, cowgirls, we have the great Kayla Muscle here from Chilliwack, British Columbia, riding this weekend. She's the first cowgirl in professional rodeo to ride saddle bronc horses, and she's here this weekend. And a superstar all the way through. Kayla Muscle will be the first cowgirl to go on a horse called Mick Martini, one of them black and white horses from the WWE Rodeo Spring, and this cowgirl can ride. Kayla Muscle, ladies and gentlemen, will be the cowgirl to go. And a lady that has been in the winning seat for many times over. As the young cowgirl is number 1 in the BCRA so far in the 2013 season standings. She won herself first and second at the Williams Lake and indoor and at Kiskiox as well. She won Clinton and debut number 1 at Bella Coola. Ladies and gentlemen, this cowgirl can ride. Nick Martini, the horse, and Caleb Muscle sitting up. Very good spur in motion right from the point of the horse's shoulders back to the cattle under saddle. And a successful 8-second ride for the Canadian. Cowgirl, ladies and gentlemen, give a big round of applause. That cowgirl can ride a bucket horse and tabulate a score for the young lady. And get ready for the next cowboy. That'll be Ryland DeRose. Ryland DeRose, ladies and gentlemen, is going about here to show you exactly what saddle bronc riding is supposed to look like. A lot of you folks have probably been following the Calgary Stampede this weekend. Ladies and gentlemen, no need to go to Calgary when you got it right in your own front door. Ryland DeRose, ride, cowboy, ride. Ride him and sit up. Ryland DeRose looking good, cowboy. There you have it, 8 seconds, ladies and gentlemen, and a successful ride for the Cowboys, the 2012 Rookie of the Year. Our bigger man, Archie Williams, getting him safely to the ground. Give him a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. He can hear you all so loud and clear. And you're going to see the man back here for section number 2 later on this afternoon. And ladies and gentlemen, out in the crowd, don't be afraid to hoot and holler. Let them know you came here. Barrel racing, we have it all after the bull riding this afternoon for a slack edition of the rodeo. Clayton Honeymore and all his hands is outside, charging hard and fast, trying to drop that rodeo arena. Got himself a hard-to-catch longhorn cow, takes a flying dismount, puts the loop on the front end, brings up the hind, goes to wrap the tie. He's done. Give him a big round of applause. Looks like he's clean on the barrier as well, and the judge's flag is still in his pocket. Now he's ripping it down there, making sure everything is all fair and square. Now the calf must remain tied for 6 seconds on a slack rope. Adam Clark gives a nod, and ladies and gentlemen, we have a time. Come charging out of the barrier box after a longhorn calf. The guy letting off his head nuts outside, charging down into your rodeo arena, breakneck speed, throws a loop, and he's got himself a longhorn calf. Crowd, your time to come alive. Help the cowboy out, get the adrenaline going for the man. Put the biggest ring on the front, but brings up the two hinds, going for the wrap, a tie. He's done. Give him a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Guy letting the 108 cowboy. The popper off the cowboy tried it into your rodeo arena this time. A Palomino horse. Oh, that Braden Roach. Sorry, Braden Roach in a new time for the cowboy. A new time for Braden Roach in a new time. Well, some of the quickest hands in the sport of rodeo. Bring the popper off. Tried it down. Got himself a black calf and crowd. This is what I meant about a fast kid with fast hands. He put a biggest string on the front feet. Now bring up the two hinds, go for the wrap. He's done. That's how it's done, ladies and gentlemen. It's a boil of motion for the kid from Risky Creek. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I shouldn't call him a kid. He's a new father. He's just the father of a young, new youngster and a proud new father. 16 years of age and under in the juniors, and that's what he is. He's just a junior competing against our seniors, veteran Cowboys. The crowd greeted him like a lot of us fine folks. When it comes to the youngsters, you cheer a little louder, a little harder, and don't be afraid to hoot and holler at any time during the rodeo. You paid to come on the end of the gate, and when you paid the gate, you have that opportunity to hoot. You have a opportunity to holler. You can boo, you can clap, whatever you want at our rodeo. Troy Gerard charges down. He's got himself a calf, and ladies and gentlemen, that's how it's done. The clock kicks away against the young Cowboy, races down the length of that rope. That horse working good for the Cowboy. Puts a loop on the front foot, brings up the two hinds. Starts getting the full route, one route. Gonna take a quick half hitch. He's done. Give him a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, for the Savannah Cowboy, Troy Gerard. This could be one of the quick runs of the rodeo. He's already had himself a win earlier this season, ladies and gentlemen, like I said earlier. He won himself the Princeton Rodeo, and he's back here to win the Canoe Mountain Rodeo. Tom Hanson outside, charged it down to the rodeo arena, got himself a black calf. Takes a flying distance, a horse working well for the Cowboys. Ski paws him on, grabs that calf, throws him down to the ground, put the picking string on the front foot, brings up the two hinds, goes for the wrap, the tie. He's done. Give him a big round of applause for the Cowboys. Rodeo judge gives a nod and have a 12-4, getting up for second spot so far. Forward makes him charging hard and fast. That's a black cap. Throws a loopy down. Takes a flying disc out and crowd come alive. Help him out and he throws the calf down to the ground. Grabs him up the biggest tree on the front foot. Brings up the two hinds. The wrap. He's done. Give him a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, for the young Cowboy, Kamani Campbell. Cohort Mason with a 12-7 is the running time. We just got to make sure that calf doesn't need to stay tied for 6 seconds in order for that time to stay. As a 12-7 to number third spot so far this afternoon in the tie down, Robbie. A 12-7. And then we'll go down to the steer wrestling. Marty Reese charging hard and fast down across that rodeo arena, throws a long loop. Comes up with an empty rope and it takes himself a no time. Give him a big round of applause this weekend, ladies and gentlemen. Unfortunately, the truck cowboy from Canoe is always going to be taking home your applause in no time.
Can you tell us a little bit about how you got started being a rodeo announcer?
Well, it started out, I was a competitor in rodeo for quite a few years, and I went to auctioneering school, became an auctioneer, and a lady at the British Columbia High School Rodeo Association called me up and said, look, we're in dire need of an announcer. You have sound equipment, you know rodeo, we need you. Can you try giving us a hand? You know, we know you never announced the rodeo, but can you help us out since you know a little bit about it? And you can talk over a microphone, that's since you're an auctioneer, can you give us a hand? And I thought, well, I'll give it a try, and just started going from there. I did a couple of high school rodeos, and then Andy Copeland, a well-known saddle bronc rider in northern British Columbia, called me to go up 1 year to go do a Northwest Rodeo Association approved rodeo up in Fort Nelson. And after that, people started hearing me, and I've just been on the road steady. I usually do between 8 and 14 shows a year.
On the amateur
level, and then a couple years ago, I went and did a couple of pro shows with Joe Braniff, who 7-time Canadian champion and rodeo announcer. I worked with him a couple of rodeos and learned a lot, and it's been great so far.
Back into the barrier box, ready to throw a long horse steer down to the ground in the quickest time possible. Dodds and Henson outside, reaching down, grab, oh, right off the front end of that steer, and takes himself a no time, and a no time for the Quinnell Cowboy, Ty Jasper, and a no time. Robert Bernal's head reaches down, got a long reach across that rodeo arena. Crowd come alive and help him throw a steer down the ground in record time. And Robert got it done. Give him a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, our first successful Cowboy in the steer wrestling this afternoon. He's been all over Western United States and Canada winning money in the steer wrestling, and he's here to win this weekend. This is Luke Suminen out of Darrow Matter. Nozzle hits it outside. Charger down to your rodeo arena, reaching down, grabs a big long horse, steer with a horn and crowd. Come alive there, Melvin! And ladies and gentlemen, that's how it's done for the Cowboys. A 7-0, the running time of that, your new leader, ladies and gentlemen, a 7-0 for Luke Suminen, a 7-0. On the heads it outside, charging down here, rodeo arena, takes a flying disc, grab him, steer by the horn. God help him out, he's just a small man, trying to grab a would throw him down, wrestle hard, push him over, man. Yeah, there we go. The Cowhead is meeting this morning. He's ready this afternoon for the bull ride in action later on with the Cowboys. A 17-5, the running time of 17-5. Conley Henson outside, charged it down hard and fast, out of the steer by the horn. Throws him down, trying to get him down, hang on, go horn, trying to come alive, get that adrenaline going for the Cowboys. That's how it's done, the Cowboys. We got some bad news, Cowboys. 10 seconds added on to your time, a little bit too quick on the takeoff. You get that 10-second penalty added on to your time. A 10-3 plus 10, superstar in heart, and a huge man when he hits the size of a small steer by the horn, the lead of the gentleman's guy can throw it all down to the ground. Andre Astell, grab the long horse steer, crowd come alive. That man got himself a lot of steer, it's all done. Give him a big round of applause. But Andre, a little bit too quick on the takeoff, takes himself a 10-second penalty. A 5-9, but unfortunately a 10-second penalty gives him a running time of 15-9. And ladies and gentlemen, like I said, he's a superstar in the rodeo arena when he gets the hold of a longhorn spear. Crowd, are you guys ready for a cowboy to wrestle a spear down on the ground? Well, ladies and gentlemen, this cowboy is ready to give you that treat. This is Andy Farmer. Like I said earlier, he's been on a winning streak. Call his head to the outside. Reaching down. Go, Andy Farmer! I gave up with an empty arm and a new time. Give him a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, and a new time. At this time, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to thank the folks that made it all happen this year, this weekend. I'd like to thank the Super 8 Motel, Premier Mountain Lodge, North Water Park, Spiral Contracting, Canoe River Campground. Without your support, the rodeo would not be possible here this weekend. Talk Cowboys and Cowgirls, and all the support is always appreciated. And ladies and gentlemen, out in the crowd, don't be afraid to hoot and holler. Let them know your game here. Watch a superstar in action. Bob Griffin, if you head back toward the bucket chute, you lost your eagle feather. All down there. You don't want to go anywhere without that. Head to the rodeo dance without an eagle feather in your cap is not going to happen very well for you. Every time he dances with a pretty girl, he puts a feather in his hat. So tomorrow morning, Ron will be tricked out in feathers. You know that, don't you? And this afternoon, around number two, he's on a horse called Kitty Hawk. Kitty Hawk has taken a lot of cowboys to the bay window, ladies and gentlemen. This bay horse can buck. One of the nice, calm, quiet horses, ladies and gentlemen. Outside of the rodeo arena, you can walk up and pet this horse almost anywhere. Nice, quiet, gentle horse in the arena, but when she's got a cowboy on her back, she likes to buck and throw a cowboy down to the ground. Kitty Hawk, the horse, and Ron under Rose will be the cowboy. Todd Henson outside, and crowd, here's your cowboy, Ron under Rose, like a champion. Across that rodeo arena, give him a hand, he can hear you loud and clear this afternoon. As Archie Williams rescues our Cowboys down on the ground, the judges score the Cowboy 1-25 in his riding ability, and a 1-25 with the bucking action of that horse, and Ron under Rose, another successful ride for the Cowboy. A 67 is what he has, and after round number one and in second spot. It's Caleb Muscle, the Canadian Pro Rodeo Cowgirl. And Cowboy, and Cowgirl, you got a roll! Not often you see that happen to that Cowgirl, but ladies and gentlemen, you're in your matchup against the BCRA Bucking Horse of the Year, the Saddlebrook Riding Event. It's hard to say what's going to happen, and that horse does buck. Caleb Muscle, a 71 round number one, a buck off in round number two. And it's no disgrace to get bucked off that Hollywood horse. What do you guys think of the bucking horses here this weekend? Some of the finest, will you ladies and gentlemen, that black and white horse in the barnyard pit. They tell me Barbie wants to make that horse into a barrel racing horse. And we have ourselves an exhibition ride in the saddle dog riding of it. This is one of the horses that Caleb Muscle rode 2 weeks ago for the championship in Delacula. Victor Young, the cowboy on the saddle rock horse and ride, cowboy ride, home! Vic in a little bit of trouble all over here across that rodeo arena. Give him a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, just riding for his entertainment and yours as well. The bigger man, Archie Williams, gets him down on the ground. Give him a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, this exhibition rider, Victor Young. The first to go will be Troy Girard, to be the first cowboy to go. A young man that's a champion all the way through in the junior division of rodeo. Currently, I do believe, in the number two in the standings so far for the junior all-around championship. And he finished fourth overall in 2012 in this event. That'll draw second to Clinton and date number two with Elk Lion Lake. And he's not going to be a champion this afternoon. The bay horse holding the rope for the cowboy. Out of that rodeo arena, throws him down to the ground, puts the biggest ring on the front foot, brings up the hind, does the tie. He's done. Give him a hand, ladies and gentlemen, for Derek Moggs. The cowboy from Merritt, British Columbia. This Merritt boy is roping well this afternoon. There's a wait to make sure this calf does indeed stay tied for a total of 6 seconds. The judge gives the nod. A 10-9. A 10-9. Good enough for second spot so far. With a 10-9 for Derek Moss. Breaks away, and that's how she does with the cowboy, Troy Girard. With a running time of 3-8, it is a running time for Troy Girard. On the hands to the outside, Morgan Fosbury charges down, but throws him down into the ground and takes himself a no time, and a no time for the Merritt Cowgirl, Morgan Fosbury. All their hands to the outside, charges down across your rodeo arena at breakneck speed. The roan horse working well for the cowgirl, but she throws him down over the shoulder of that horse, that ear, and ends up with a no time. Give her a big round of applause and a no time. Cobb's head sits outside, charged it down, got herself, oh, and a no time. Give her a big round of applause and a no time for Rika White, a no time. Start down, it comes up with an empty rope, and a no time. Give her a big round of applause, going off, and you see that happen, that cowgirl, ladies and gentlemen, and a no time for Laura James, and a no time. There's a Jasper, straight out to drive into the rodeo arena. Look, breakneck speed, a harder pass. He got himself a cap. Breaks the way, and that's how it's done for Ray L. Lunicky. Well, they're tapping on their time to get ready for some more rodeo action. A 5-0, good enough for second spot. A 5-0, the running time for Ray L., a 5-0. At this time, ladies and gentlemen, we go down to the bucket shoots for the K.D. Spears, the junior steer riding event.
What's your favorite part of announcing?
Just being there to help the kids out, kind of boost the egos of the kids. Some of the ones that aren't doing so well, you can kind of take a youngster that's not doing well in the standings and boost their ego up and make them feel good. And, you know, with a kid with their ego pumped up, they tend to ride a little harder.
You see that young cowboy throw it to the ground. And a championship cowboy in the making, and that was Wendell William out of William Lake.
Yeah, that guy's got confidence in me. That got confidence in myself. And I find it helps the kids out a lot. I enjoy helping them out.
The dad down there on the shoot gate, the former steer wrestling champion. We'd have maybe have a paramedic available, please, on the ground. A paramedic might want to have a look at that young man. He took a pretty good kick to the chest and he was dismounting. We'd have a paramedic down to the arena, please. It would be greatly appreciated. We're hoping to ever have to use the services of our paramedics here on the ground. Ladies and gentlemen, we appreciate them for being here just the same. That young man took a heck of a hook coming off of the dismount off the back end of that steer. A 73-point ride, they tell me a 73 for the young cowboy. Ladies and gentlemen, made himself a good qualified ride. We hope the youngster is okay down there as he gets the first aid treatment. His dad and brother down there with him trying to keep him calm. And then even up to the paramedics. Give a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. A tough for young Wayne Manuel of a 150-mile house, a heck of a way to get a dismount. And currently in the lead of this event with a 73-point ride for the young cowboy. Across British Columbia. Justin Spears is shoot number one is where the action is. The young cowboy, you just saw his younger brother in action. And now these young cowboys here to show you what he can do with the older brother, Justin Spears. For the judges' decision on this last ride. The cowboy, the judge, the 125, and his riding ability on the 125. On the bucking action, a steer across the rodeo arena. That young man riding like a professional bull rider, one hand down. Oh, yeah, this is Jeannie Merriam, a young lady from Outer Barrier, British Columbia, here this weekend to show the boys what steer riding is all about. Kirby in the lead of this event, Wayne Manuel with a 73. Kirby in the lead so far. Bucked off of one of these steers here this weekend in a no score. Unfortunately, for Jamie Meyer, about a barrier and a no score. And this kid, ladies and gentlemen, on a great day can ride. This season, he decided he's going to ride one handed and a force to be reckoned with in the junior steer ride. It is a Craig Loring. Had himself a second and third place finish at Ballycoola this year and a 2-3 split in Anaheim Lakes. And this kid, you know, ladies and gentlemen, can be in the winner's circle. He knows how to ride, and he can be the champion this weekend. A 73 currently in the lead of this event. This is young Craig Loring. Well, I have, ladies and gentlemen, a successful ride for the young cowboy from Clinton, British Columbia. A vocabulary score for the young cowboy riding one hand like a pro bull rider. And you get ready for some more junior steer riding action here this afternoon. The young cowboy will get herself set up and she's ready to ride. Once again, this is Ricky Laviolette from 150 Mile House. They see a re-ride, the judges see a re-ride for the young cowgirl and a re-ride. Give him a hand, ladies and gentlemen, that's where the ride should have ended for the young cowgirl. Had a little bit of tough luck. Unfortunately, a no score for young Tyler Antoine and a no score. Ty Myers, they tell me the cowboy, I'm very sorry, Ty Myers, he's the next cowboy to go. Monty Hansfield, British Columbia, all the hits and outside. Well, a hand for the cowboy, and another successful ride here this afternoon. The judges have it in score for the young cowboy, Ty Myers, out of Hansfield, British Columbia. Ty Myers, judge of 125, his riding ability in a 125 with a bucking action of that steer throughout the 8-second ride. Our rodeo judges, Dallas Root, Adam Clark down there tabulating for the cowboy. A 64-point ride, ladies and gentlemen, a 64 for the cowboy. Currently in the lead of this event will be Wayne Manuel of 150 Mile House. Championship Cowboy in the making, and that was Wendell William out of William Lake, and an old score for the young Cowboy. His score of a 1-25 and his riding ability at a 1-25 with a bucking action of that steer for a total possible 100 points. Early in the lead of this event, Wayne Manuel, the first man out this afternoon of that 73-point ride. Give her a hand, ladies and gentlemen, for Ricky Laviolette, the young lady from 150 miles. That's what you call a championship cowgirl, ladies and gentlemen, doing the dance and the wave and all. And Adam Clark and Nick Dallas, Ruby Tavalik, and scores of the youngsters. A 68-point ride, ladies and gentlemen, good number second spot so far with a 68. Point ride.
Thank you. once again at the Chinook Riders from Hinton, Alberta. So ladies and gentlemen, get ready for pack horse racing this afternoon. Now the idea of the pack horse race, ladies and gentlemen, is they must remove the pack saddles, the panniers and pads from the back of the horses and off the saddle horses. As they start them out, ladies and gentlemen, they must throw the pack saddle and saddles on the saddle horse and on the pack horse and lead that mount up on the saddle horse and lead the pack horse around the barrel. The team that of course does this for the passage of time with a complete diamond hitch and in place at the end of the race will win the event. But all we have to do is wait for the slow farmer to take the pack saddles, the panniers off the horses. Tony Parigi a little bit behind the time. I don't know if Tony's hoping for an early start of the race or trying to just be a little bit slow to kind of intimidate the others on team number two. The girls are ready, Tony, they're waiting on you, cowboy, get ready. And you, the crowd, you can hoot and holler, you can boo, whatever you need to do. You'll join the show this afternoon. The two teams, they have the Duncan Girls and the Snow Farmers. So are you guys all set up and ready to go here, guys? Tony, are you ready or are you just going to play with that rope for the afternoon? You're going to play with the rope. Well, I hate to tell you this, but the crowd's not cheering for you, cowboy. They're hoping for the pretty girls over on the far side. You just spice your team up with one pretty girl, but you're not going to help yourself out a lot. She's just there to tell you guys what to do and how to keep it going straight. Are you ready, Tony? Slow riders instead of snow farmers. You bet that's what they might be. Now, you girls know how to do this. Duncan girls, you know how to do the race? You know how it's done. Tony, can you remember how it's done? I didn't think so. Are you guys ready? When you drop the horn, we'll holler go with them whenever you're ready. Drop your arm, judge. And go! We have ourselves the pack horse race, ladies and gentlemen, cheer on. The Duncan girls. And the snow farmers, everybody getting the saddles and panniers in the back saddles in the place. Saddles going up on saddle horses. It looks like the snow farmer slightly in the lead at this time, but maybe the gentleman that could change at any time throughout the duration of the race. The young lady on the far snow farmer's team saddled up her horse. Ladies on the Duncan girls also getting the job done, and the Duncan girls are already ready to start putting panniers on. And this could be a one fast and furious game. The idea though, Tony, I think it'd be a lot more fun if you took one of the bucking horses from the WWE string and used it as a pack horse. That would liven it up a lot. The cowgirls are out in the lead. Tony, you gotta hurry. The kids are gonna show you how it's done. Come on, old timer, grab that panier up. The cowgirls are already mounted up with the saddle horse and getting ready to throw the tarp on. Tony, hurry up. Come on, guy, get going. Tony, you're not at work anymore. You gotta move a little quicker. Tony, you must have one of them union kind of jobs. They just gotta get slow on the takeoff. The Duncan girls are mounted up high. They're diamond hitch across the tarp, getting everything all set and ready to go. Where do these cowgirls know what they're doing down there? That's right, they got the hooping and the hollering going on, ladies. Come on, cowgirls. Tony's starting to gain on you. Snow farmers getting everything in the pack saddles, the panniers in the place. The girls have got it all together down there. The cowgirls are all mounted up. Snow farmers still getting the panniers in the place. Time to dive and hitch, and these Duncan girls look like they know what the job is, how to get the job done. Caught up with the bucket horse, the Duncan girls turn hard. Oh, the barrel, you don't have to go too hard. It's taking Tony forever to get that horse up, standing up. Horse doesn't have to do with the cruise along. Just, oh, the saddle horse a little scared of the legs, but you better hurry, cowgirl, if you want to get ahead of the snow farmer. Back horse is taking it in stride, but that saddle horse is not having any part of the flag along the fence. Hang in there, cowgirl, you're almost there. You gotta make a complete turn around that barrel. You're almost there, don't charge too close to the wall. Around the barrel, give her a big round of applause. The Duncan girls, Ward Andrews down there to make sure the pageant stays in place, the diamond hitch is tied. Tony, we have a horse race going on. today, you're going to enter up to today's performance, not tomorrow. The pushing and the pulling. Tony's going for the tie. Gord Anders trying to saunter on over. Gord must be working, working. You have a job with Tony, don't you, Gord? The girls are clean all the way through, they say. Snow Farmer's mounting up, getting ready to go. And she's mounted up for the Snow Farmer, headed back. And they come into the barrel, and the race is on, and heading into the barrel. Cowgirl's got the horse on a good lead. Leading around to go, give her a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, for Snow Farmer, Tony Parisi, Woody Woodland, and Jan Krakenbusch. That's how it's done. Get the big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, to pack our race show this afternoon. Gord Andrews, is it true the Duncan girls are the champions today? Give them a big round of applause. The Duncan girls are your champions. That means Kimberly, Atlanta, and Stacey Duncan, the winner of the pack horse race. Drop that rodeo arena for number two on the black horse, working hard for the cowgirl. Well, the short barrel is number three, and a nice clean roll. Hang on, Char. Around number three, have a little bit of tough luck there. That's what you call it. Cowgirl, give her a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. That cowgirl riding hard. And unfortunately, at no time, and at no time, for trouble, Bob. Fishbowl horse out of the ground, barrel number one, across that rodeo arena from barrel number two. Of the cloverly shaped pattern, looking down from barrel number three as the clock ticks away. And fish out and around three, a nice back turn, and heads on for home. With a running time of 13.898. This is Sue Riley out of Chase Murphy, Columbia. Sue comes charging in on barrel number one on the left hand side. The bay horse here working well for the cowgirl. Across the rodeo arena for number two and two down for the cowgirl. Down for the third and final barrel. And Sue Riley's got a good run. How to give her a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. With a running time of 13.930. 14.930. Mary Farmer charges up on left hand barrel, makes a take left turn on one. Across the arena for number two, the Jessup horse working well for the cowgirl. Around two and down, focus on the number three barrel this afternoon. Around three, all three standing, give her a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Mary Farmer with a running time of 15.023, 15.023 the running time. Following this cowgirl, we rake around our barrels and come back to you with some more barrel race in action. This is Renee Wills of Princeton. Renee charging hard about from Palomino around number one and around two barrels standing as she head down for the number three barrel, and it's around three. Get a big round of applause. She heads it on home for the speed demon this afternoon with a running time of 15.333. I'll give him the Darla Cork. I put out for the club, yeah. Not out and around number one, across that arena from barrel number two in the cloverleaf pattern. Two barrels standing as you head down to the third and final barrel. Give her a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, for the crown cowgirl, Darla Cork, with a running time of 15.546 to the home. So Salvador will be the next cowgirl to go here this afternoon. Jack Yoder around one, across that arena for barrel number two for the Savannah Cowgirl. The bay horse working well. She head down to the number three barrel. Give her a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, for Jackie McNeil. With a running time of 13.845. And there's your new leader, ladies and gentlemen, with a 13.845 in the 2012 season. This young lady won Kiski off the batter hook earlier this season, second in Anaheim Lake and day number two in Alkali Lake. And off the ground to be a champion this weekend. Big baby horse working well for her as she heads around the barrels and around to number two, three, and she's all done. Give her a big round of applause for Laura James with a running time of 14.425 plus five. This is Monica Orham of Salvador, followed by Ronald McLeod of Monty Creek on deck. Colleen Duggan will be in the hole. Monica out and around number one. Tried to cross for number two, just a little wee lady and a great big horse coming hard for number three. And around number three, give her a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, from Molly from Oro here this weekend. With a running time of 15.418 plus five. Ronald McLeod on the big gray horse charging in hard and fast. Look at barrel number one. A Nice bird on the water. Big Jay focused on the cross that arena for barrel number two of the globally pattern. In around two down to the near end of the arena for barrel number three, the third and final barrel. Give him a round of applause, all three barrels standing. As we stop the clock with a running time of 15.687 of 15. He's the leader of the champion. And Pauline Duggan, the next car girl from out of Gastry. Pauline Duggan on round number one across that arena for barrel number two. The Globally Pattern, a good run happening. For the cowgirl down for number three, the sorrel horse working well around three. Give a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, Pauline Duggan. For the running time of 14.010 plus five, little Chelsea Griffin. A young cowgirl that came up from the high school rodeo ranks and now competing in the BCRA rodeo. Chelsea Griffin charging hard and fast for barrel number one. The big brown horse working well for the cowgirl round number two. She got a good run happening so far. And she looks down to the number three barrel and round three. Give a big round of applause. And her down coming in Chelsea Griffin. The running time of 15.207. Well, followed by Destin Gerard on deck. Bernie Zanette will be in the hole. Sierra Super charging hard and fast for number one. The long hair flowing in the wind as she goes. Hard for number two, good run so far for the cowgirl. Focus down for number three. A nice turn on three. Give her a big round of applause. They hit the hole this afternoon. Sierra Stupa with a running time of 15.581 of 15. 5.14.845 by Jackie McNeil and seven on currently in the lead of this event. And little Jesse Gerard. Jesse Gerard charging hard and fast for barrel position number one. Nice right turn on one. Across that rodeo arena for barrel number one and the must lead on one. Working hard for the cowgirl. Close to the barrel in round number three. Odessa charges home. Give her a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, the young cowgirl. For the running time of 13.920, 13 barrel races after the bull riding in our slack edition of the rodeo. It'll be Courtney Burnett of Salmon Arm. Courtney charging hard and fast for barrel number one. Take the left lead around number one. Across your rodeo arena for number two. And they're looking good so far. Down to the far end of this arena for number three. The third and final barrel. Give a big round of applause. As you head down our home with a running time of 15.335. A 15.335. It's the first cowgirl to go. Young cowgirl had a second and fourth finish earlier this season. It's been a good on the long weekend. And you're here to be a champion this weekend. This is Sophia Smith. And a gas peak out of around barrel number one. Looking across her rodeo arena for barrel number two with a corporate pattern. And a nice turn on view down to number three, the last and final barrel. A nice beautiful turn on three. Get a big round of applause. Sophia Smith turned it home with a running time of 15.679 of 15. A third spot finish at this Josh and William Lake, North of Patterhoof. And one day number two with Alkali Lake Rodeo earlier this season. He's back here to be a champion this afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, the young cowgirl, Mariah Mannery, out and around barrel number two. A little tightened, ladies and gentlemen, that's good. I'm going to wreck it. Got under the knee of the cowgirl. And around number three, give her a big round of applause, Mariah Mannery, for the running time of 15.482 plus five. In the team rope event, her and her dad entered the number 8 team rope and got a good and won that event on day number one. Now Harvey Antoine's here to show you what she can do with a barrel race event. Holding around barrel number one. Across the arena for number two, Harley Antoine's got a good run happening so far. Down and around number three, get a big round of applause. A nice clean run for the cowgirl. For a running time of 15.469, a 15.469. Here to be a champion again this weekend. Again, this is Tally Hill. Started out on the left-hand barrel around number one. Across your rodeo arena for number two. The clock ticks away for the cowgirl. A tight turn on two. Goes on a little bit of steam and overdrive for number three and hits home. Tally Hill, the cowgirl with a running time of 14.912. There's Harvey Wardrop out of Houston, British Columbia. The next cowgirl to go here this afternoon. Following this young lady to rake her out our barrel arena. Breakneck speed on the big bay horse. The left-hand lead around number one. Charging across the arena for barrel number two. These short barrels makes it a little tough for a long-legged horse. They head down the far end for barrel number three. And around three, give her a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, for the caller, Charlie Wardrop, City of Houston, with a running time of 16.36.
All right, that is the cavalry on deck. Ricky Lowry led at 150 mile out, a lead in the hole. Felicia Duco in round number one, across that rodeo arena from barrel number two of the Cloverly pattern. And the clock kicks away from the caller, down to the number three barrel. And around three, give her a big round of applause, she heads on home. Felicia Stupel with a running time of 16.715. Starts in hard and fast from barrel number one. Janet has done a good run, happening so far with the young lady as she heads around for barrel number two. The big round working well, digging in deep. Charges fast for number three. Give her a big round of applause. Coming on home. Janet Kelly with a running time of 15.251. 15. Two Brooklyn Myers will be in the hole. Ricky Lyman over to round number one. A-horse lineup started across that arena for barrel number two with a covering pattern. Looking down the arena for barrel number three. Give a big round of applause. They head to our home, ladies and gentlemen, for Ricky Lyman. With a running time of 15, two of the cover right here, ladies and gentlemen, this is Alyssa Pfeiffer, unavailable. Alyssa charged in, looking at barrel number one. The throw horse line out of the round barrel number one across the rodeo arena, looking at barrel number two. Well, that's around number two. Hang in there, cowgirl. Make them do what you want them to do. She charges and focuses down on the third and final barrel. Well, that's not a good run happening so far. Give her a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Your hometown cowgirl. The running time is 31.568 She's the next one to go, followed by Clay Farmer on deck. Vanessa Cavalry will be in the hole. Brooklyn Myers, the last Atlanta competitor in our junior division before we get down to the BBs. Brooklyn out around number two. She focuses down on the far end of the arena, down with a bucket shoot for barrel number three. Out and around number three. Give her a big round of applause for the Blue Wall River Cavalry. She heads home with a running time of 22.382. Ladies and gentlemen, in the PB barrel racing, this young Clay Farmer charging hard and fast for barrel number one. Nice run on one. Looking across that arena for barrel number two. Clay sitting up at this young kid can ride. As he head down for number three, the third and final barrel. Give a big round of applause for Clay Farmer here this afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. He stops the clock for the running time of 16.856. At 16. Charging in on a little paint horse, looking at barrel number one. Nice turn on one, looking across your rodeo arena for barrel number two and around two. A little too tight, but ladies and gentlemen, this young cowgirl sitting up and looking good. Around the third barrel and heading for home this afternoon. And stop the clock with running time. That was British Columbia. Following Emma Antoine on deck, Ellie Farmer will be in the hole. Kaylin James out and around number one, across your rodeo arena for barrel number two. The big sorrel horse working well to the cowgirl as she focuses it down for number three. A third and final barrel in round three. Give her a big round of applause. She heads on her home for Kaylin Jane too this afternoon with a running time. But she's here to be a champion. The young Emma Antoine of the Gas Creek, British Columbia. Followed by Ellie Farmer on deck. Gracie Antoine will be in the hole. Emma Antoine gets the big white horse around number one. Looking across that arena for barrel number two. And a right turn on two. Charging on hard and fast. Our barrel number three, that's the third and final barrel. Give her a big round of applause. She heads on home, ladies and gentlemen, for Emma Antoine. With a nice clean run in the running time at 22. Fourth place finish at Clinton Meatball and also team number two of the Bellaclue Rodeo. So they had a third and fourth place finish at Alkali Lake. And this young lady riding well and doing a fine job this season as she heads in for barrel number two. Bay horse working well and Gracie Antoine, a nice tight, tight turn on two. And around three, give her a big round of applause to the Gas Creek Cowgirl with a running time of 16.145 in this event. Danica Stupel out and around barrel number one. Looking across that arena for barrel number two of the Cloverleaf pattern. Horse all painted up and he's headed to go to town and all fancied up. Looking for barrel number three and around three. Give her a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, for young Danica here this afternoon. For the running time of 19.80, Van Arulapolis, the horse charging in hard as fast for barrel number one. On and around barrel number one, looking across that arena for barrel number two. Get her under control, and the lady got her in for number two and around two. Take the left lead around number two. Having a little bit of difficulty with this young cowgirl and up, and she's going to make it all happen here with the young lady from rural Alberta. Lexi Byers round number three. Give her a big round of applause. She heads on home here this afternoon. Unfortunately, no time for Lexi Byers to get ready. This is Madison Smith right here from Belmont. Don't forget, ladies and gentlemen, this afternoon, following the bull ride, we go to our rodeo slack. That's barrel racing and team roping, a little bit of tie down roping, I do believe, as well. A whole lot of action happening after the bull riding this afternoon, the rodeo slack. And then at 9 p.m., the rodeo dance. So, ladies and gentlemen, please make sure you have a whole lot of fun. Phone your friends and neighbors and come on in on the rodeo this weekend. As you come into barrel number one, your hometown cowgirl. Round number one. Madison Smith of Belmont looking across that arena, trying to get herself lined up for barrel number two as the clock kicks away. Madison Smith on the big gun horse around two, looking down to the far end of the arena, down by the bucket chutes for barrel number three. Round number three. Madison Smith at hometown, cowgirl headed for home. Hang in there, cowgirl. You got a lot of horse under you. Hang on, cowgirl. We go with Kaylee Kinley Dawson right here from Belmont, British Columbia. She's the last and final TV barrel racer here this afternoon. Before we go down to the junior pole bidding, so all your junior pole bidders, get ready. Just a little wee lady on a good horse. These Fjord horses, ladies and gentlemen, they're soft little horses, and they make excellent kids' horses, these horses. I have a few friends over in Alberta that raise these horses. They claim that very, very seldom do you have one that I even have shown a little inkling of buck at all. They're perfect for a young kid, these few little Fjords. Hey, Kimberly Dawson goes around barrel number one. Get him lined out. Kaylee looking at number two. On around number two, Kaylee Kimberly got it figured out. Heading down to the end of the arena. He's going to show that horse who's boss and get down the bucket chute for barrel number three. Haley Kinley, Dawson, ladies and gentlemen, give her a big round of applause at hometown, cowgirl. For a running time of 44.673, a 44.673. This is Charlie Wardrop out of Houston, British Columbia. Charlie charging hard and fast for number one on the Serpentine pattern. And this young lady sitting up and looking good on the big bay horse, Charlie Wardrop, down to the far end, makes a turnabout and starts back in the second section of the Serpentine pattern. So far, got a good run happening so far for her. And give her a big round of applause for the young lady, Charlie Wardrop, as you head to our home this afternoon for the running time at 24.217 out of Cash Creek. Charlie charging hard and fast. Starting in our Serpentine pattern, this young lady sits up and looking good. She heads down to the far end of the rodeo arena, does a right hand lead chain and comes off back to the second section of Serpentine pattern, all pulled, moving. We're standing as she heads her on home. Give her a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, for Hardy Antoine out of Cash Creek for the running time of 23.425 plus 5. Lane wheel charging hard and fast. This young lady sitting up and she's got a horse that can get the job done. Ladies and gentlemen, could be one of our fastest time of the afternoon. And this young lady's got a good run happening. The big horse knows how to run a set of poles. This kid can ride around and give her a big round of applause. Lane Will Darnell with a running time of 21.915. Plus five is a total running time of 26.915. The 26.915. If you just started in our summertime pattern, this young horse and ladies work well together, ladies and gentlemen. Ducking and diving, fishing around the poles, and come back for the second section. This is Sophia Smith out of Cash Creek. Give her a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. She brings it on home this afternoon with a running time of 24.867 and 24.867. This is Mackenzie Will, that Grinnell news from you. A young lady that can get the job done in a hurry from Grinnell, B.C. Starting in our serpentine pattern for the young lady. Got a good run happening so far. Out and about with the young cowgirl Mackenzie Will heading back to the second section of the serpentine pattern. Give her a hand, ladies and gentlemen. She heads it on home for Mackenzie Will with a running time at 22.198 plus 20. Good at her for this Columbia. Followed by Tanisha's Duke on deck, and Brooklyn Byers will be in the hole. And then Jamie Myra on her gray Arabian horse headed back for the summertime section on the bullpen event. Hurricane Scott Watts this afternoon. Got a good run happening so far for the young lady. You give her a big round of applause. She heads it on home for Jamie Myra. The running time at 25.928 and 25.928, the running time for Jimmy. Headed to go will be Tanisha Stukal on a Caledon will be the next running goal. Tanisha Stukal, followed by Brooklyn Byers on deck. Kaylin James will be in the hole. This is Tanisha Stukal charging in hard and fast to the serpentine pattern. Tanisha working hard as she head down the far end of the arena. So the right hand lead, Jane, and comes on back to the second section of the serpentine pattern. It's her against the stopwatch here this afternoon. Tanisha got a good run for having to give her a big round of applause. A nice lead run for Tanisha. But she stopped the clock for the running time at 28.539 and 28.539. Derek will be after this one, sorry. I forgot about you, Jessica. You're on another list. Jessica Derek will be the last and final unit bullbender. The next one to go will be Jessica Derek will be the next one to go. This is Brooklyn Byers out of Brule, Alberta, the next fitness cowgirl in the arena. Brooklyn Byers, Brule, Alberta cowgirl. Heading back to the second section of the serpentine pattern. Got a good run happening so far for the lady. Give her a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, Brooklyn Byers, Brule, Alberta. Her hometown of the running time at 29. Jessica Derrick should be the last and final junior pole bidder before we get down to the PB pole bidding. So Kaylin James, get yourself ready to ride, cowgirl. This is Jessica Derrick. Jessica starting in her serpentine pattern. Makes the turn about and started back to the second section of the serpentine pattern. Still this afternoon, this is Jessica Derrick. Give her a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Nice clean run for the cowgirl. This is Jessica Derrick for the running time this afternoon of a 39. She'll be followed by Emma Antoine on deck. Madison Smith will be in the hole. This is Taylin James. Cowgirl run up, cowgirl tail. Taylin ride that pony. And she heads back to the second section of the serpentine pattern. Taylin James heading back home. Give her a big round of applause for the little lady from out of the gambling country this afternoon. Thank you. Emma Antoine out of Cass Creek. Emma charging into your rodeo arena towards the bucket, shoots a breakneck speed. Cardo with a left hand lead in the serpentine pattern, takes form as she heads back in the beginning of the races. She came in the gate and led the general nice speed run so far. Very hand point. Makes the right hand lead change. Started back in the second, sends that serpent time pattern. And a nice speed run happened so far. Your hand, ladies and gentlemen, should be going on home here this afternoon for Emma Antoine out of Cass Creek. For the running time of 36.900 or 36.90. Adam Clark, if you can hear me, are we going to rake out this cowgirl? This will be number 6. Yeah, okay. This is Madison Smith of your hometown, Congo, right here from Elmo. Once again, this is your hometown, Congo, Madison Smith. Starting in our serpent time pattern. It's all up to mom to see how much speed this youngster can handle. Madison Smith down to the far end of the serpent time pattern, starting back. Around the last and final pole, ladies and gentlemen, give her a big round of applause as she heads it home in her hometown, Congress. A superstar in the making as she heads it for home here this afternoon. There you have her, ladies and gentlemen, your hometown, Congress, Madison Smith. And unfortunately, a new time for our cowgirl, and a new time for Madison Smith, a new time. Ladies and gentlemen, please bear with us as we rake around our barrels and come back to you with some more barrel racing action. Emma Antoine, the only qualifier so far in the BB pole betting. This is Gracie Antoine out of Cass Creek, charging in on our big bay horses, darting in on our serpent time pattern. This young lady having a good season so far. She can ride that big bay horse, and she knows how to run a set of poles. Gracie Antoine, Cass Creek cowgirl. Got a good clean run happening so far. She ends up finishing out her run and give her hand. A nice clean run for Gracie Antoine with a running time at 26.669. Alexi Byers on her little Appaloosa horse charging into your arena at breakneck speed. Alexi starts in on her serpentine pattern and she knows what pole betting is all about, this young lady. Alexi Byers from Brule, Alberta. Makes a quick lead change and started back in the second section of the serpentine pattern. And out and around, give her a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, Lexi Byers here this afternoon. And a young man is becoming a force to be reckoned with in the barrel race at the end of the pole betting. This young Brock Everett of 150 Mile House. He'll be followed by Chase Cohort on deck. Brock Everett on the Palomino horse, starting into the serpentine pattern. Got a good run happening so far for the Cowboy. And down to the far end, starting back in the second section of the serpentine pattern. And he's got a good run happening so far for the young man. Give him a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, the young Cowboy, Brock Everett, here this afternoon with a running time of 28.541. For Lucas, will be Chase Cohort out of Canoe, British Columbia. The young son of Trish Cohort, our BCRA Rodeo president, and this is young Chase Cohort out of the Vanderhoof country. Just a little guy on a good little horse, and ladies and gentlemen, this is where cowboys and cowgirls start their rodeo careers. Chase Cohorse out and around number one. This horse knows how to run a set of poles. The Chase get him under control, the Cowboy. Hang in there and get him under control, young man, and you got to figure it out. That's right. They're going to show Mom what barrel racing is going to be about in a few years' time. I can tell he's going to be the one warming up the horses and getting everything all set up and ready to go. This is youngster Craig. This is young Chase Cohorse. Here you have them, ladies and gentlemen, young Cowboy Chase Cohorse here this afternoon. Unfortunately, a new time and a new time. Good try for the young Cowboy and a new time for Craig Cohorse. And now, ladies and gentlemen, continue on. Here, open event. The barrier open stretch across to an able that's near to get a fair 10-foot head start in this event. And Dustin's Beard's got a horse back to the barrier box all set up and ready to ride. He'll be a champion this afternoon. Draws it his and let me have at him as he comes charging out of the barrier box. Throws the loop down, pops it off the top of the head, and takes a no time. Elaine rolls back to the barrier box, getting herself set up, and she's ready to ride here this afternoon. Rope sprints across, and she's ready to be a champion this afternoon. Draws it his and outside, charging into the rodeo arena at breakneck speed. Throws the loop over the front of that steer, and takes herself a no time. And a no time. All lane wheels will take home with no time. Two steers this afternoon. So far, no qualifiers in the junior breaker early. And Shauna Hancock hoping to be the first one. Throw the loop down. Takes a no time. Give her a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. On the hits is outside. Troy Gerard charges it down. Does a little bit of fishing, but he's got himself. Hopefully, a little bit of steer there. Trying to get himself a head catch at this time. Up the end of the nose and takes a no time. Give him a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, and a no time for Troy Gerard. Cross, this young lady is ready to rope. Be the champion this weekend, hoping to be the number one contender, hoping to be the first one to make a qualified run. Hardy Antoine charging into the rodeo arena. Throw the loop down, but on no time, unfortunately, no time. I think they do believe Archie Williams and Cash Creek will be on the heels. And ladies and gentlemen, a lot of our Cowboys and Cowgirls here this weekend have the capability of ripping a long horse deer in about 6 seconds, and that is what could possibly happen here this weekend. This is the team of Aaron Palmer, Archie Williams. Aaron Palmer back in the barrier box, getting himself all set up and ready to rope one of these long horse steers in the WWE Rodeo Company. Johnson hits it outside, Aaron Palmer goes for a horn kick. Dallas makes a turn, Archie Williams for a set of heels, comes up with an empty rope, and it takes themselves in no time, and a no time for Aaron Palmer and Archie Williams. Crane got his horse back to the barrier box, the rope stretch across. Johnson heads it, let me have a long horse deer. Crane slows him down, into the round, and takes us all in no time. A lot of matters, Chris Cohorse, one of our contenders in the rodeo, spent a lot of time with the team roping events, and she is also the British Columbia Rodeo Association president for 2013, in her second year as the president, doing a fine job for us in the rodeo office. They are the next two to go. They'll be followed by Jason Gerard and Troy Gerard on deck. Laura James, Carl Hyde will be in the hole. Laura James back to the barrier box. Rope stretched across. Father Henson outside, trying to harden the rodeo arena. Laura James goes for a horn catch. Dally makes a turn. Trish Cohorse go down for a set of heels to come up with an empty rope, but they take it on time. Give them a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. All the ladies are taking home with them. Jason Gerard and Bay Horse back to the barrier box. Get things set up and ready to go here this afternoon. Hope to be the one to make the qualified run and be the fast time of the rodeo. His young son Troy, one of the top contenders in the junior division of our rodeos, will be on the far side picking up the heels for him. Dawson heads it outside. Jason Gerard charges it down, goes for the horn catch. Dally to make the turn. His son Troy goes for a heel catch. Comes up with an empty rope, but they get themselves in no time. Give them a big round of applause and in no time. Barrier open, stretched across, and Laura James will be on the head end of things in this event. Carl Hyde on the far side picking up the heels for him. Hoping to be the first qualifier in the fast time of the entire rodeo. Laura Nasa hits it outside. Laura James charging hard and fast. Throws the loop down, comes up with an empty rope. And they take themselves in no time, and a no time for outside of Camus will be on the head, and I think Mark Colorado Savinar will be on the heel. Charge it out, Aaron Palmer goes the horn, Cat Jelly to make the turn, Mark going in for steady heels. A pal, she's done, give a big round of applause, and we've got a plus five for only one high foot, and a plus five for only one high foot for the team of Aaron Palmer and Mark Baldwin. A 6-2 plus five in the total running time of 11 and...
I see a lot of... Well, I don't know how to explain what we call city slickers on the rodeo circuit, but a lot of people that don't understand it coming and making negative comments about how the animals are abused, and that's not true at all. You look at the stock in the back, they get fed better than most people's pet horses and saddle horses. They get the three rash in the day, and a lot of these horses are rescue horses, because who wants a horse that's going to buck you off? If it wasn't for the stock contractors buying up these horses at buck lots, they'd be slaughtered. And a lot of people don't understand that. They think, oh, you're making them buck, you're putting flanks on them. But if we didn't make them buck, where would they be? And it's sad. I feel more people need to come and actually get more involved in the Western lifestyle before they make negative comments about it.
Antoine Archie Williams will be the last McDonald team in this afternoon performance of our rodeo before we go down to the bucket shoot for the bull riding. Troy Gerard back into the barrier box. Rope stretched across, and this cowboy is ready to ride here this afternoon. Tom is headset outside, charging hard and fast. Troy Gerard throws a loop down. Oh, we had him and it got away. And unfortunately, a no time. We're going to team the team rumpers before we go down to the bucket chute for the bull riding. So bull rider, there's only three more teams before we go down to the bull riding. And then following the bull riding, we start our afternoon slack edition of the rodeo with the ladies wrangler podium. Well, it's an event. And the ladies and gentlemen, make sure you get a good watch of these two cowboys. Got off when they miss a spear. 11-2, the only qualifier so far. Neil Antoine back to that barrier box. Rope is stretched across. The man is ready to be a champion this weekend.
I take this weekend off. Her daughter is in the
these horses like any mind to that people exactly what's expected of them. Neil Antoine wanted to make sure that steer is focused on the far end of the arena. The steer is charging out at breakneck speed and needs that horse also be focused on the steer and waiting for the cowboy's cue. Oh, the headset outside, charging across that road of the arena. Neil Antoine, pulls the horn, gets Dally to make the turn. Mark goes down, a set of heels. The foul she done, but 5 seconds and penalties for only one hind foot. 5 seconds added on. A 7-6 plus five. Craig will be on the head end of things. Trish will be on the far side, picking up the heels for him. We get down to our last two and final competitors in our afternoon performance of the draft and equipment team rope event. Miss Team Rope, you enjoy, ladies and gentlemen, following the bull riding and our slack edition of the rodeo. We'll have some more team roping happening. Craig Cohort for the long catch. Had him by the horns and she popped it off, but in no time for Craig Rodeo Trail. They are the two to watch at this time. 11-2 currently in the lead by Aaron Palmer, Mark Pazabon. Neil Antoine, Mark Pazabon with a 12-6 in his second spot so far. And now Neil Antoine has got himself another healer. It's a matter of seeing how fast the time can be done in this event. Then we go down to the bucket chute for the bull rider event. So all you bull riders, get ready. Bulls are in the bucket chute. Rope is stretched across. Neil Antoine got himself back to the barrier box. Horse is focused on that steer. The head is outside. Charged it down. Go to the horn cat. Mr. Daly in a new tire. Give him a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. How many want to see some cowboys thrown to the ground? Now the best question of the afternoon, how many want to see a bull rider get ran over? Nobody. I'm the only one that wants to see a bull rider get run over. Ladies and gentlemen, there's no way these cowboys are getting ran over by a bull. They're two of the finest in the business, ladies and gentlemen, and they are here to put their lives on the line. Our first cowboy this afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, is going to be Colton Manuel. Be the first cowboy to go this afternoon. He's number four in the BCRA standings. This young man did one day number one at the Alkali Lake Rodeo, was third at 100 Mile House and fourth at William Blake, the young cowboy that can ride a bull. You saw him earlier in action in the steer wrestling event, and now you have Colton Manuel on a bull going as Wild War. The time, ladies and gentlemen, for the time for the bullfighters to shine. Great Loring Jr., GM Holmes, yeah.
You've done lots of rodeos over the 20 years. What's your favorite memory you have on the rodeo circuit?
Oh, I have lots of memories. I think the best bull riding memory that I can have is here, it'll be about about 6 years ago, Vancouver Island, Marlon Williams rode the Great Bull Global 8 from WWE's Rodeo String for a 92-point ride. And my wife does rodeo photography, and you can look underneath the belly of that bull and see about a foot and a half, 2 feet of top of the bucket chute between the bottom of that bull and the ride that Marlon rode, and it was just spectacular. Her photos were everywhere on it, and it was just great to be there in the crowd, and everybody was pumped up for it, and that's not often you see a 92-point ride.
How long have you been doing the Valmont Rodeo for?
I think this is my seventh year. Yeah, they've been in production here for 8 years. This is my seventh year here.
Do you like coming to Valmont?
Oh, I love it. The people here are good. Bob and Lorna do a great job. They treat us like gold. You know, it's one of our better shows, and it's great scenery around here. And the crowd gets quite involved. They've had ups and downs with this rodeo, of course, and they're on a good comeback. It's looking good. This is the most entries we've ever had here at Valmont, and it's had a promising look for it.
And coming to the Irene Blackman is $270 richer and 270 friends.
And how many years has the rodeo been going on here in Valmont?
8 years. This is our eighth year this year.
Can you tell us a little bit about how did the Rodeo Association get started? It's, you know, it's a small town, and it's a great rodeo event. How did it get started?
Well, I had BCRA approach me, and seeing that I was kind of central, and they wanted me to try it for a year. And so we started out small with no equipment, and we went in the hole the first few years badly, but we kept it going, and it's getting better all the time, especially with our high school rodeo.
So that the high school rodeo starts to bring a lot of more attention to the area, and now the fact that you've been doing it for 8 years, you're really starting to get some attention here. So how's this year's rodeo been going?
It's been going really good, but we're really hurting for sponsorship, and that's like we've got to have more to keep going with BCRA, because they're more expensive than the high school rodeo, so we need more input from the community
for
sponsorship.
So what kind of sponsors, I mean, just obviously the people of Valemount are watching this, so what kind of sponsors would you be looking for?
I'd be looking for like anything, whether it be a $10 crescent wrench to put into a basket for a raffle, or a $100 donation, and then you put your, we put their businesses on a day sheet, which is really good advertisement, or we hang up a sign behind the stands, which it covers the high school rodeo, the BCRA, plus our mud bogs. It all happens here.
So how important is sponsorship for this rodeo?
Well, for the rodeo itself, it's really important because it's really hard. We just can't survive without it.
Right. So there is a serious risk that if you don't get enough sponsors, you won't be able to do this again next year.
Well, it's definitely true, and especially true for the BCRA. And they come from all over BC to this. And it's a great big plus for the community because they shop. They buy gas at the stations, and they, mechanical, keeps their mechanics going. Like, a lot of guys break down, gets their mechanics to come down and fix their rigs or whatever.
And so this year it seems to have a lot of competitors, a lot of events. How many competitors are here this year?
We got 200, and I believe it was 287 this year, and it's pretty record. It's really good.
And so those people, obviously, they come with families, they're not coming alone, so there's a lot of people coming into the into Velma.
Oh yeah, there's a lot of people come in, they shop at the stores, and they go to the A&W. Like, it's a big spin-off for the community.
Right. Has anyone done a study to see kind of what the economic spin-off would be for this rodeo?
No, they haven't.
Well, I'll bet you it's in the many, many thousands of dollars over the weekend.
Oh, it definitely is. It's unbelievable. Like, we buy lots of beer and stuff for our beer gardens from the liquor store. It's just unreal. And people go in town to shop. And it's unreal.
So a lot of spectators here yesterday. The weather was a little bit nicer, and quite a good turnout for spectators.
Yeah, I believe we had about 300 yesterday. The stands were full, and it really helped. We took a good gate in, and I'm hoping today to pull us out of this, but we might be able to survive.
That's great. And I noticed you had a lot of local competitors as well. Everything from kids all the way up to adults.
Yes, that was up also. People are starting to take an interest, and they're giving the children riding lessons, and then they're entering the local events. And usually it's 2 to 4 locals. This year it's 20. Maybe next year it'll be 40.
Wow, that's fantastic. So this is an event that I can only see growing, and hopefully more people will get out and support it.
Exactly. And I think it's a small token for a sign on the back of our stands to cover all 3 events for the year. When they see that sign up there, they're thinking, well, there's some good supporter. Maybe they're going to Belmont and buy something.
So if people do want to get on board with supporting, who should they contact?
Just phone me, Bob Griffin, at 566-4500.
Great. Anything else you'd like to add?
I'd just like to add, please come out and try to support our rodeo.
Excellent. Well, great. Good luck with it, and we'll see you again next year.
Thanks a lot.